Assalamu alaikum. I welcome you all for class 8 subject science. So today we are going to start a new topic, that is light. Can you see the world without light? Yes. How will you see the world? With your eyes, yes or no? The world is largely known through the senses. The sense of sight is one of the most important senses. Through it we can see mountains, rivers, plants, trees, everything, so many other things around us. We also see clouds, rainbows, birds flying in the sky. Okay, what helps us to see? That is our eyes. Yes. What makes things visible now? Have you ever thought how we see various objects? Not only, for example, close your eyes. Can we able to see? No, that is an organ which helps us to see. But once the eyes are there, but it, what happens at the night or it is very dark? When you enter a dark room, are you able to see the things? Yes? No, you are not able to see the things. What is the main reason why you can't able to see? That is the light. The light is not there, means you are not able to see with your eyes also. Eyes are there, but still you are not able to see in the dark. It means that eyes alone cannot see any object. It is the only when light from an object enters our eyes that we see the object, any object let it be. The light may have been emitted by the object or may have been reflected by it. Okay. So what is light now? You have already learned, let us revise once again. It is a form of energy that enables us to see around us. Okay. We can say that it is an electromagnetic wave that can travel through medium as well as through vacuum. It is a, what is light? Light is an electromagnetic wave that can travel through medium as well as through the vacuum. If any medium is there, it will travel. If even in the vacuum, it can travel. So what are luminous objects and non-luminous objects? The objects which allow to light pass through them are known as luminous. Okay, which will allow light to pass through them, it is known as luminous. And those which do not has its own light are known as non-luminous. Okay. Sorry, what is luminous? Luminous means are those which have its own light. Okay. Which has its own light is known as luminous. For example, sun, bulb, it has its own light. Those are luminous objects. Which do not have light are non-luminous objects. For example, chair, desk, everything comes under non-luminous object. Okay, when light falls on any surface, either of the phenomena takes place. Like light falling on surface may be get observed or no. Okay, which can get observed is transparent. Okay, which will observe and make it pass through them is the transparent. Which will not observe means which will be black, which will not give them to pass through them are known as, those are opaque object. Now the other thing, few are there which will allow light to pass only a little, those are known as translucent objects. Light on falling on surface may pass through the surface. For example, here you can see in this 100% the light is passed. Okay, therefore it is a transparent object. Here only half of them it is passed. Okay, fully 100% is not passed. It is 40%, those are translucent. Now here if we say it is an opaque object where the light cannot pass through them. So now we will learn what is the word reflection. Okay. Reflection is nothing but whenever the light is falling on any surface, it will bounce and go back. Okay. Strike. Now it is bouncing and back to the light rays on striking the surface. This is a surface. Okay. The light ray is falling here. From here, it takes an angle and it reflects. Okay. It moves. The rays will move backward. That is the reflection. The word reflection means what? It is the bouncing back of light ray. What is reflection? It is the bouncing back of light ray on striking any surface. Where can we see the reflection now? On what characteristics? Means everywhere can we see? No. We cannot see the reflection everywhere. We have few characteristics where the bright light reflects. That is, it should have shiny surface, it should have polished surface, or it should have smooth surface. These three surfaces makes the light to reflect. Okay, makes the light to reflect. That is shiny. You can see here in the figure. So how if the light will reflect and move? If any surface is shiny, the reflection can be seen. Or polished also can be seen and smooth. Or when you play with your watch, when the sun rays are falling in the class, you will play right with the watch. What happened there? You can see some rays on the wall. The light, that is the same shape of your watch, can be seen on the wall. That is, the image is formed from their watch on the wall, where the light is getting reflected on your watch. Okay, from the watch, the other light is, that is other rays coming back and forming an image. The same thing we are going to learn deeply here in this chapter. So what can you see here? Now once the light ray falls on any object, the reflection is formed. Right, in the reflection there are few lights, as I said you. The first ray from the sun which is coming to the surface, or from the light, or from the bulb, the ray which is starting and coming to the surface is known as the incident ray. What it is known as? Incident ray. The light ray which strikes any surface is called the incident ray. The ray that comes back from the surface after reflection is known as the reflected ray. This is the reflected ray. This is the incident ray. It is the ray that strikes the surface. Now this is the point of incident. What it is known as? Point of incident means where it touches the surface and moves back. At which incident ray strikes the surface is known as point of incident. Then the reflected ray, the ray comes that bounces back on striking the surface. Now what is the normal ray? Normal is exact 90 degree. This is the normal ray. Perpendicular drawn to the surface, it will become the normal ray. Here three rays we have. That is incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal ray. And here you can see the angle, right? The formation of angle. And this is our surface. Now, what are the laws of reflection? Incident ray, reflected ray. You have incident ray and the reflected ray and a normal ray, right? All will lie on the same plane, that is the surface. The angle of incident, where is the angle of incident? This is the angle of incident, which is pink in color, which you can see. The incident ray is falling towards the normal. If you take, this is the angle of incident. And here, this is the angle of reflection. From the normal, we have to take the other side. Okay. So, there are three lines, as I said you. Incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal ray. The angle between the normal and the incident is known as angle of incident. The angle between the normal and the reflected ray is known as angle of reflection. Now, these both are equal. Okay, these two angles will be equal. Therefore, it is, what is this known as? This is known as law of reflection. The law of reflection says that the angle of incident is always equal to angle of reflection. These two angles are equal. That is the first law of reflection. Here, point sources. No, sources that are too small in size means any source which have the, which does not have the exact height. Okay, it will not have the height, the source of the light. For example, sun. Okay, sun will not have the exact point. So that is very small. Now, finite source means exact height. If we have the proper height, as we can see the candle, here we have the exact height of the source, that is known as finite source. Point source means we don't know the exact height of the what? The source. Where, from how much height it is there, that is what? Point source. Here it is finite means where we know the height of the source of light. That is, source of light may be candle, may be bulb, may be sun. That is, if we know the height, it is known as finite sources.